Although the 8X version 3.1 specification has been out for quite some time, it still creates confusion among users, PSU manufacturers and brands. In this short video, I will shed some light on the 12V 2x6 cable requirements. Can all 12V 2x6 cables handle up to 600 watts of power? Although not all PSUs should come with a 600 watt setting on their 12V 2x6 sockets, if they are modular units, or cables, if they only have fixed cables, all 12V 2x6 cables should be able to handle up to 600 watts of power. Why is that? Someone might wonder. From the moment Intel specifies exactly which PSUs should use 600 watt, 450 watt or 300 watt settings on the 12V 2x6 sockets or cables, why should all cables be able to handle 600 watt? The information in this table is not available on the 8X spec, but only in Intel's test plan. As you can see, not all PSUs should have 600 watt settings on their 12V 2x6 cable, but only those with 1100 watt power or higher max power. The native 12V 2x6 socket is the only standardized socket in the desktop PSU market, with all the rest being non-standardized. Each PSU manufacturer uses the sockets it finds better on the modular boards of its PSUs, which is why you shouldn't mix cables from different PSUs. On the other hand, users can use any 12V 2x6 cable as long as it can be connected to the native 12V 2x6 socket, because some 12V 2x6 cables connect to two 8 pins on the modular panel. These cables are not universally compatible, of course. So, Intel thought that some users might get a cable from another PSU to use, and if this cable could handle less power, say 300 watt, it would probably melt or even worse, catch fire if it was asked to handle 600 watt. This is why Intel decided all 12V 2x6 cables should be able to handle 600 watt, meaning 16 AWG gauges for the power and ground lines, even if they are used in 750 watt PSUs with a maximum setting of 300 watt. Moreover, Intel recommends that the power labels be only written on the cable when it is fixed to the PSU. In the case of modular cables, there should be no label on the cable, but the label should be on the PSU's power specifications label. I hope I have shed some light on this sensitive topic. According to Intel, using 18 AWG gauges on the 12V 2x6 cable is incorrect, even if it is used by 750 or 850 watt PSUs where the maximum power setting is 300 watt. This creates some problems for the manufacturers and brands because 16 AWG cables are more expensive than 18 WG ones. And imagine if you have to manufacture thousands of PSUs knowing that this extra cost will be in vain. I can fully understand this, but on the other hand, I can also understand Intel's effort to make the 12V 2x6 cable safer, given that it is the only standardized cable in the PSU market. Hopefully, Intel will also manage to standardize the rest of the cables, because it is a shame not to have a standard pinout for all PSU modular panels. It would make our lives easier and lower costs, because if your PSU broke, you could get another one without cables, saving lots of money. Or you could buy a PSU and only the cables you need so that you would save money. It is a great shame to have all these cables set aside being useless in the end, especially in PSUs that come with a vast amount of them. To answer the article's question title, yes, all 12V 2x6 cables should be the same, meaning they should use 16 AWG gauges for the power and ground and 28 AWG for the sideband signal pins.